gets 79.9, he is not a good at all. Those who get, I give you a line, just 80% and above marks, very good student, good student. Okay? Those who get 79% or 79.99% is a bad student. That means is it complementary? Okay, good. The complement of good is bad. So it is a bad, he is a bad student. Can you conclude it? No, at all. So the fuzzy comes. So there is ambiguity. Okay? Now, fuzzy logic reflects how people think. It attempts to model our sense of words, our decision making, and our common sense. As a result, it is leading to new, more human intelligent system. So this is actually the fuzzy logic. Why fuzzy logic? Why we are thinking about fuzzy logic? So it will increase your thinking power. Thinking power. All the powers of thinking. So every time we are thinking about the thinking. Now our thinking power, if you think, our thinking power is infinite. If you think this, infinite. But when you write it in your page, what you think, that is finite. That must be finite. Now, in mathematics, we say that just we write all the conditions, thinking, all the conditions. When you model it, then it becomes only one or three or five finite number of equations, not infinite number of equations at all. So, our thinking power is infinite. But when we express it in words, then it becomes finite. Okay, so fuzzy logic gives all the concrete descriptions about your thinking power. Okay, so our thinking, so we think about what is called fuzzy. Now, in 1965, Lotti published the famous paper Fuzzy Sets, in which he first introduced what is called fuzzy logic. What is called fuzzy logic? First paper is actually within the inverted, that is inverted comma, that is actually fuzzy sets. Jade extended the work on possibility theory into a formal system of mathematical logic and introduced a new concept for applying natural language terms. Okay, I use that terms. So what is the natural language terms that are used in Jade's paper? This new logic for representing and manipulating fuzzy terms was called fuzzy logic, and Jade became the master father of fuzzy logic. He is the father, master of our fuzzy logic. Now, just a question, I guess there is a term. This is a term. So, in probability theory, when it starts, probability theory, there is a term, random experiment. Its first term is called random experiment, and there is another term is event. There is another term that is event. You see, in a probability theory, you see that there is a term probability, there is a term event, and random experiment term is there. Random experiment is an experiment which can be specified into random experiment is an experiment under identical same conditions. Random means same conditions. And event, particular event is there. So in fuzzy set theory, there is no term of event. Okay, now you see that membership function, I describe what is called membership function. You see that membership function also lies between 0 and 1. And probability also lies between 0 and 1. So why we read probability, instead of probability I read fuzzy set theory. So difference is that there is an event term is there, and event is specific. Okay, but here it is not so. Why fuzzy arises? In physics theory, quantum mechanics, we are searching a particle is where. A particle is where. Suppose inside the body, there is a particle. Search it. Inside my belly, there is a, suppose there is a germ is there. Search it. Okay? So what is the probability that the germ is there? Now what is our motto? First we just area, find out the area. What is the sub-region? And sub-region divided by the total area. just divide it. That is the favorable number of cases, that is the total number of cases, divide them. Okay, if it is approaches to near approaches to 1, you see, then most probably the particle is there. Most probably the particle is there. Okay, so you use the term most probably, what does it mean? So it is called fuzzy.
Not certain.
You not sure that the particle is there. Now, experimentally, when you experiment that just USG is there, then the particle is not there, because in USG there is a ray is there, so the particle is from here to here, it is moved from here to here. So if you apply ray from ray using USG, say I saw the particle is where, then using that force, the particle is not moving from here to here or here to here or here to here. So it is not a particle's position at all. Okay, so just I use the language, most probably the particle is there. Okay.
Sir, it is showing that physics is the principle of uncertainty. It is showing
that same thing is there. Parvurtikar uncertainty principle ke change kora hoyeche. Change kore amra phaji sector te convert koreche. Onek paper beriyeche. Oi je particle position, that is quantum mechanics. Ha? Ota ke hocche convert kora hoyeche. Parvurtikar. Now, why fuzzy? Jade say one line, and Jade said the term is concrete. Okay? Immediate and descriptive. Every term is concrete, immediate and descriptive. However, many people in West were repelled by the word fuzzy because it is usually used in negative sense. Your thinking power, that thinking power term is also, I do not know what is the actual membership function or actual truth value is, what is your thinking power. I say good boy, I say one term good boy, what is good boy? I do not understand what is good boy. Tall man means? Those who beyond 180 centimeter tall man. Okay, then another question arises, 179. Okay, I just give you some graphs. That graphs gives actually there are some regions in which that is increasing up to certain level, that is that after that this is 180, then it is to that all of them 180, then 181, 190, all of them are greater than that portion. Okay, that are all tall men, and they are certainly tall, mostly tall, most probably that are tall at a certain range, up to a certain range. Okay, most probably this term actually fuzzy terms, that is linguistic derivative. I go through the next slide. So another, why logic and fuzzy and logic, why fuzziness rests on fuzzy set theory and fuzzy logic is just a small part of that theory. Fuzzy set is a long theory, but one subset is that the small part is actually theory. Jade used this term fuzzy logic in a broader sense. In broader sense, he used that is actually the fuzzy logic. You use it in fuzzy logic sense. Now, everything, proof. When a statement is given, in mathematical, some statements are given. Prove that in your logic theory also, prove that you are a good boy. Prove that you are a good boy. What is your plan? Next year algorithm is that you must prove that you are not a good boy. You are not a bad boy, sorry. Your thinking is that. That means if we construct a bad boy set, you do not belong to the set. You just establish it. Okay? In what sense you are a bad boy? You prove that you are not a bad boy. In what sense? So you cannot think it about the matter. I think that sob somoy porikkhay 90 er opore pacchi. Sudhang ami to sekhane establish kore dilam je ami kharap chhele noy. ওকে আমি তাহলে ভালো সেটে বিলং করেছি কিন্তু ভালো টার্মটার মধ্যে অনেকগুলো দেখবে ক্যাটাগরি ভাগ আছে দ্যাট মিন্স তুমি পড়াশোনায় ভালো তুমি চরিত্রে ভালো অনেক রকম টার্ম সেখানে দেখবে টার্মগুলো বসে আছে তুমি তো একটিকে প্রুফ করে রেখে দিয়েছো যে আমি ওই পাচ্ছি বলেই ভালো ছেলে ওকে কিন্তু এই দিকগুলো তো বাকিগুলো তো চেক করছেন না ওকে সেই কারণে আমরা ফাজি এবং লজিককে সেখানেই দেখবে এস্টাবলিশ করেছি একসঙ্গে ট্যাগ যাদের সেট দ্যাট you must tag them fuzzy and logic these two terms are added so that it will give a broader sense you can use it in every sense you can use it okay now what is fuzzy logic fuzzy logic is a set of mathematical principles or for knowledge representation based on degrees of membership rather than on Cripps membership of classical binary logic. That means I just give you a line, just either one or zero. ঠিক আছে? Beyond that, you think between zero and one, fractional value. You take the fractional values. So that is actually fuzzy logic. Unlike two-valued Boolean logic, fuzzy logic is multi-valued. Okay? It deals with degrees of membership and degrees of truth. That is a term that is called degrees of membership and degrees of truth. So what is next we go through? What is membership function or like that? Now, fuzzy logic extends classical logic by simply expanding the role of characteristic of membership function. Logical conductive are like that, maximum function that means like that. So these are the mappings, I do not go through that point. But the point of fuzzy logic is not abstract manipulation of truth values. Just you calculate 1 into 1 equals to 1, 1 plus 1 equals to 1, that does not. So you say that, but the point of fuzzy logic is not the abstract manipulation of truth values. So if you take the data, that is actually abstract. 2, 5, you cannot see it. What is 2, what is 5 you see? You cannot see it. Just this is an abstract manipulation. It is not designed to serve in a construction of a mathematical proofs like there are infinite number of primes. I know it. There are infinite number of primes. From which source I cannot know, but there are infinite number of primes. To prove that portion, to design the fuzzy logic, to build the better reasoning methodology, that is the Vogue information. Okay? If P is a proposition in the form U is in A, where A is a fuzzy set, for example, big pressure. Suppose it is big pressure and Q is the proposition V is bin B, for example, small volume, then one encounters the following problem. What is the problem? How to define the membership function in the fuzzy implication P implies Q? That means big, big pressure means small volume. Okay, that implies means big pressure means small volume. I think why fuzzy? That means big term is not concrete term. Small is not concrete term. So B implies Q means that means big pressure means small volume. In 9-10 syllabus you say Boyle's law PV equal to constant. So P equals to 1 by V, constant by V. That means if pressure increases, then volume decreases. Okay? Now, equivalently, I say AU equal to BB. It is clear that A implies that should be defined point wise in this way, should be function of AB, like that. So, I can define in the mapping way like that. This is actually our implication factor. This is an implication operator. This is our implication operator. In this way, we can write. This notation can be written in this way. That means A implies B U B. That means A U implies A B. That are all membership functions. Fuzzy corresponding to implication A and A B are fuzzy sets on X and Y respectively. So in this way you can define the relation, fuzzy logic relation in this way. Fuzzy and logic theory can be implicated in this way. So this is actually called implication operator. Okay. Now, in language you see that, in our interpretation, AU is considered the truth value of the proposition, U is the big pressure, and B is considered as the truth value proposition. very small volume. That means U is the big, U is big pressure implies V small volume is equivalent to A, like that A U is implies V D. That is the membership function. That means this implies, this means U is big pressure implies V is small volume. Okay. It should be remarked that most of the implication operators owe their genesis to logical identities. Of course, using classical logical identities may be the wrong way to approach the problem of designing an implication operator. This is because many results of classical logic are not true for fuzzy set theory. For example, the law of excluded principle states that the statement must be true or false. Either it is 1 or 0. But fuzzy logic theory states that this statement can be 0.7, 0.7 is true and 0.3 is false. Like that. Knowledge-based system. In knowledge-based system, you see that if it is raining, then open your umbrella. Okay? First, you see, if it is raining, then open your umbrella. There are several question arises. Several question arises. Because when raining, then open your umbrella. Okay, but another case is also there where it is also sunny, then you also open your umbrella. So there are so many situations are there, but I conclude when you are in your class, when you are going from your home to your class, your mother says when it is raining, then you must open an umbrella, but when it is sunny, she did not told me that way. Okay, so if it is not raining, we do not even think about this rule. Okay? And would care less what it says to do. This is because fuzzy logic is application not for symbolic manipulation. Symbolic manipulation is important. Without it, we would not have digital computers. However, symbolic manipulation is not the goal of thinking through. Some have claimed this is true.
Okay. We display the
now in fuzzy logic uses continuation of continuum of logic values of 0 completely false and 1 for completely true. Instead of just black and white, it employs the spectrum of colors, accepting that things cannot be partly true and partly false at the same time. Same time, you see that partly true and partly false. I think I just give you an example. Here is a glass is given and half glass, there is a water. What is your conclusion? Okay?
Two conclusions may be there.
And
half is empty, half is
full. So
filled up.
So decision makers is important here. That means
how you view it. Yeah.
Yes. My drishtibhangi. Mane apna ekhane jara achen tader prottekey drishtibhangi ta ki. Je optimistic se dekhbe je half glass bhorti hoye ache. আর যে পেসিমিস্টিক সে দেখবে হাফ গ্লাস খালি হয়ে আছে, তার ওই দিকে ওই দিকে লক্ষ্য আছে. ওকে, সো হিয়ার ডিসিশন মেকারস, দ্যাট মিন্স দ্যাট ইজ কল্ড দ্য ডিসিশন মেকার. অপটিমিস্টিক অর পেসিমিস্টিক এনি হাউ দ্যাট আর কল্ড ডিসিশন মেকারস. সো ডিসিশন ইজ হোয়াট উই ক্যানট ডিসাইড ইট ইন মাই মাইন্ড অ্যাকর্ডিং টু ভ্যালি দে আর ভ্যালি বিকজ ইফ আই টেক হিয়ার হি সে হি অর সি সে that is half is full. Okay, yeah, I take the voting process. So what is the voting process? Start here, all of them half is full. Because all of them are optimistic in mind. My result is that means all of them are optimistic in mind. But if some of them gives half is full and half is blank, then what is your decision? All of them are optimistic or all of them are pessimistic, you cannot conclude it. Okay? So in this case, this fuzzy logic rule is very important. Okay, I just draw the curve that what there is a number given, that number is actually those who cross this amount, then we say all of them are optimistic. If it cross does not cross this amount, then it is called not optimistic but pessimistic. There is a range. There actually range. Okay? So after that, when fuzzy is introduced, after that, Professor R. E. Murray, M-O-O-R-E, Murray, Professor R. E. Murray introduced a number, very interesting number. So you see, এখন যেটা বললেন যেটা হাফ গ্লাস জল ভর্তি থাকলে এদিকে বলবেন কেউ হাফ গ্লাস জল ভর্তি, কেউ বলবেন হাফ গ্লাস জল খালি। ওকে, তো আমরা এবারে ওই আর এ মুরে একটি নাম্বার দিয়ে গিয়েছিলেন, সো ভেরি ইন্টারেস্টিং নাম্বার। আই জাস্ট গিভ ইউ আইডিয়া বিকজ ইন ইউর ফাজি সেট থিওরি দিস টার্ম অলসো দিস নাম্বার অলসো ইন্ট্রোডিউসড হিয়ার। দিস নাম্বার অ্যাকচুয়ালি কল্ড, এবং ইন্টারেস্টিং ইজ দ্যাট when two equal numbers are subtracted, line mind that when two equal numbers are subtracted, that is not equal to zero, and when two equal numbers are divided, that is not equal to one, that is invented by R. E. Murray. When two equal numbers are subtracted, it is not zero. When two equal numbers are divided, then it is not equal to one. That means the number is not itself. If a minus a equals to 0, then obviously a equals to a. That means he is reflexive to itself. Okay? But Murray gave an idea. That idea is very interesting, is that beyond fuzzy set, some terms are used. Today's sensex is between 29,000 to 30,000. That is a limit. That means lower limit and upper limit is given. Within that limit, the sensex is moving. Okay? So that number is called actually interval number. So if we subtract two interval numbers, equal interval numbers, then it is never zero. And if we divide them, then it is not equal to one. So this is in fuzzy sense, in another number, that is very important. That is called actually interval number. And there are so many properties, and recently there are so many words also there that is regarding interval numbers. Okay. Now, another thing, that is fuzzy logic system. In that logic system, okay.
Because that was more for
ল্যাপটপের সমস্যা।
That any system, I think the logic system, you must produce some input data. First, some input data is given. That is actually fuzzy. You see in the left hand side, you see that can be that some gives data input. Then that can be fuzzified. After fuzzy, sir, the previous slide. So this fuzzy, because this scripts data can be inputted, and that can be fuzzified using fuzzy rule. You can transform it, your logic, use that data, and then output set, then there are defuzzification, and that is the output result. So our memory, what we'll do using that way, you see, suppose you add 2 and 3. What will do? First you input 2 and then input 3. Rule, you see there is a rule. That is actually our data. Okay, so input the data 2 and 3. Then the rule is actually plus means 2 and 3 add 2 and 3. So that gives that portion is totally using that rule, there is add them 2 plus 3. So if we input the data 2 and 3, first it is in your memory. Then what we will do, that is use the rule. Then using the rule you can get 5. Then that 5 also memorized, then your, in your mouth, from your mouth, it is the result is 5. So this is actually the fuzzy logic system. That logic system that works in this way, in this flow, the work is done. Just like my, just if we manipulate some works, that what is the logic, that logic also applied here. That is actually our fuzzy logic system. Okay. Now, so this is an example. I do not go through there. So another is, this is actually our starts from what is called fuzzy set. You go through. Now, creep set is, the concept of creep set is the fundamental of mathematics. That means a set is a well-defined collection of distinct elements. Well-defined collection of distinct elements. So if I gather all the, all of them are in a second bracket, that is also set. Well-defined collection of distinct elements. Okay. Now, set can be represented in different ways. Represented. Okay. Representation is different. That means one can write. So suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One can write in this way. Expression. Another expression is x such that 1 less than equal to x less than equal to 5 and x is an integer. Okay? So this is another way. And another way representation is that, so characteristic function method, that is actually 1, that means x equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and equal to 0 others. You see. That means whether it is belong or non-belong. Belongingness, non-belongingness. So this is called actually characteristic function. You see, in classical set theory, creep set A on X of X is defined as a function chi X, is called characteristic function A, where chi A X equals to 1 if X belongs to A, and if X does not belong to A, then it is called, then it is 0. Okay? This set maps universe X to a set of two elements. Just it contains only two elements. You see, there are only two elements. This set, this A set may or may not contain two elements, but this set actually contains only two elements. Okay. For any element X of universe X, characteristic function chi A X equal to 1 if X is an element of the set A, and equal to 0 if X is not an element of the set A. But in linguistic term, what happens? In language, you see, universal set is a set that contains all possible elements having nature or property under consideration. If I take the students who have passed Madhyamik examination in 2016, I can take the set that is actually the universal set with that respect. But you see, that is, sorry, creep set divides the members of the universal set into two distinct groups. One of them member, other one of them is non-members. Directly member or non-member divided by decided by the creep set. And a SAP, creep set theory is governed by a logic, that is, whether it is true or false. That is our language. In language, we say that if it is true, then it is belongs to the set. If it is not true, then it does not belong to the set. So it just separates. But what is the boundary? We cannot understand it. What is the boundary? The values which not in, not outside, but in the boundary, that is, we cannot determine. So when X lies, when chi X lies between 0 and 1, that situation is described by fuzzy set. That situation. So our decision is that whether this set is belongs to the membership function 0.7 and non-membership function is 0.3, then we say that this is nearly inside our room. This is nearly inside because the membership function is 0.7, that is greater than 0.5. Okay. Now what about fuzzy set? Now this is the extension of classical set. So you see, fuzzy set is a generalization of classical set. A fuzzy set can be defined mathematically by assigning each individual in the universal set a value representing its grade of membership in the fuzzy set. Just you assign a value with their membership function, value. Membership value is corresponding assign them. I say example in the next page you see, I say 180 centimeter, I define tall man. Then we assign 180 and above numbers, centimeters are 1. That means those who belongs to 180 above, that means his gradeship is 1. And that is the perfect, that is a tall man. But those who belong to 100 and 160 like that, I grade them 0.8. That means 0.85 or like that, assigning the value. That means those who are belong to 175 or like that, his grade function is 0.8. That means he is nearly tall. Okay, like that. So, yes.
Are not we are presupposing all these things?
No. Just I assign it.
Assign.
Because I assign it. You see the term.
It may differ.
Oh, obviously. Because I just give you the idea of pessimistic and optimistic idea. Okay. The logic can represent Bob concepts and therefore fails to give the answers on the paradox. Okay. The fuzzy set theory, the element is with the certain degree of membership. You see, I just assigning it. Okay. Thus, a proposition is not either a true or false, but may be partly true or partly false to any degree. You see, there is a certain degree weightage function is there with there. Okay. In fuzzy set, transition from member to non-member is gradual rather than the uncertain or skip set. I do not go through it. So, another is that a fuzzy set is a set with fuzzy boundaries. I say, start with my lecture afternoon. What is the boundary between afternoon and noon? What is the boundary between noon and afternoon? So, there is no particular boundary at all. So, you see, no boundary with fuzzy boundaries. That means, that is Bangla, in Bengali term, that is dhuasa. Okay. In the fuzzy set, in the fuzzy theory, fuzzy set A is the universe X is generated by mu X called the membership function, and also the same, you see, if it belongs to the totally in A, then it is 1, if it is not in A, there is 0, and if X is partly in A, that is, it is 0 between 0 and 1. So, this set allows a continuum of all possible cases, so you can take all possible belonging, non-belonging, and there is a intermediate stage, whether this belongs or not, that portion is also there. So all the possible cases are included, so it is called the extension of clip set. Okay. Now we go through. So that is actually the membership function, and this is, you see that, this for any element x of universe, membership function mu x equals to the degree of which the x of the element of this element A. This degree, a value between 0 and 1, represents the degree of the membership, also called membership value of the element x in the set A. That is called the membership value. And that membership value I can assign. Okay. So, what is the membership value? Okay, what is the membership value I can assign? So, this decision can be decided recently. Fuzzy set and another fuzzy set, that is called type 2 fuzzy set, is introduced. What type of membership function you choose, membership value you choose. That is also again hesitation. So this, that is another fuzzy set that is called actually type 2 fuzzy set recently introduced.
Then we expect another 3 fuzzy set.
Okay, there are some logic also there. Because there are so many logics are also there. Optimistic, pessimistic, if you consider them, then there is a logic. But if you another logic, you must establish it. After Jade, 1986, Professor K. Atanasar, Kasimir Atanasar, he introduced another set. That is also called intuistic fuzzy set. Intuistic fuzzy set means there is a membership function also there. Also some hesitations also there. So there is a non-membership function also there. And the difference between them, that is called the uncertainty. That means the curve is membership function is like that, and non-membership just reverse of that. And the difference between them, that is the intermediacy, that is called the uncertainty. If the uncertainty is high, then the decision is not correct at all. If the uncertainty is low, then the decision is you can take it. Okay. Now, another way you can describe it, just I think a simple story that আজকে ভোট হয়েছিল একটি সিটের জন্য কনটেস্ট করেছিল দুজন এবং 220 জন ভোট দিল 110 পেয়ে দুজনে ডিসিশন হলো না আগামীকাল আবার ভোট হবে ভোট হওয়ার পরে দেখা গেল আবার দুজনেরই কনটেস্ট হলো তাতে কিন্তু 220টা ভোট পড়লো না 200টা ভোট পড়লো একজন পেয়ে গেল সাপোজ 200 না আমি আরো কম ধরে নিলাম সাপোজ 100 খানা ভোট পড়লো তাতে একজন পেল 70 খানা ভোট আর একজন পেল 30টা ভোট যে 70 খানা ভোট পেল তাকে কিন্তু আজকে আমি ডিক্লেয়ার করলাম যে হি ইজ ইলেক্টেড ফর দ্যাট পোস্ট ওকে বাট আগের দিন সে কিন্তু ওর থেকে বেশি ভোট পেয়েছিল সেদিন কিন্তু ডিসিশন নিতে পারেনি আজকে তার থেকে কম ভোট পেয়েও তাকে কিন্তু ডিসাইড করলাম হি ইজ ইলেক্টেড ফর দ্যাট পোস্ট 1800 এই ডিসিশনটাকে মেক করে গল্পটাকে মানে ম্যাথমেটিক্যালি যখন এ করতে গেছিলেন যে ফাজি সেট দিয়ে ডিসক্রাইব করব তখন সেটা ফাজি সেট দিয়ে ডিসক্রাইব করতে পারেননি তিনি তখন এসেছিলেন এই সেটে এসে এটাকে ডিসক্রাইব করেছিলেন দ্যাট ইজ কল ইন্টারেস্টিং ফাজি সেট ওকে নাও অ্যানাদার ফাজি সেট অলসো দেয়ার সো ক্লাউডি ফাজি রিসেন্টলি দেয়ার আর সো মেনি ফাজি সেটস আর দেয়ার দ্যাট ইউ ক্যান কল cloudy fuzzy and so many fuzzy sets are recently there are so many teachers so my guide professor Madhumangal Pal he also invented so many fuzzy sets and applying our optimization techniques so there are several optimization techniques you can apply it okay so so the operations of fuzzy sets on like that so that is actually these are the operations like our fifth set operations that is you see that instead of this is a maximum operator and this is actually the minimum operator is there okay now I think there is a term you see that symbol maximum of this use that symbol in a set theory book you see that either A or B or both the term is there so how can you describe that or okay So use that symbol. I could not write or A or B because A union B means either A or B or both. So there is a term or both. So use that symbol. Okay. Now membership function sets like that. So these are the properties. Commutative property, associative property and so on, distributive property, identity property and so on. Now, what is the basic difference between crisp set and fuzzy set? You see, there is a property A intersection A bar equal to 5. Crisp set you think A intersection A bar equal to 5, but not in fuzzy sense. Fuzzy set, this rule is not applied because in the intermediate state there are elements. Okay, so So this is the basic difference between classical set and the fuzzy set.
Sir,
A intersection A bar. A ta ekhane, A bar ta bar. Intersection karo. Clip set karo. Phi. Holo? Fuzzy set hai? Element ache kintu intermediate state the value dariye ache. So it is not phi at all. So this is the basic difference between clip set and fuzzy set. Either 1 or 0. In this case, so that means A intersection A bar equal to 5. But in this case, you see that A intersection A bar not equal to 5. Okay, so this is the basic difference. So you conclude that means it is not true, means false.
No.
Much more broader.
Okay.
Fuzzy, this thinking is much more broader. And it is highly influenced by the postmodernist thinking also.
Yes. There are so many extensions also there. So in every place I can use fuzzy. Yes. That means it is not true. Just there must be logic. You must apply it. So this is a commutative. You see, there is a commutative law. Okay. This law is very much important. Very much important. In a classroom, you see, lower level class, there is a mathematics. 2 plus 3, 5. 3 plus 2, 5. So 2 plus 3 equal to 3 plus 5. What is the interesting result? No. There is no interesting result. So if you convert it in language, what happens? Prottek jinte ektu hasbe, ha? Ashole ki bolben? Je dhorun line te kemon mane palte gelo dekhun commutative law byabohar korar jonno. Dadu chhele meye niye ghure bedacche, dadu meye chhele niye ghure bedacche. Line dutur modhe parthokyota bujhe. Jokhoni commutative diye dilen, tar mane kintu line er kintu poriborton chole esche. পরিষ্কার মানের পরিবর্তন চলে এসেছে দেখো ওকে কাজে ইট ইজ অলওয়েজ ট্রু দ্যাট ইজ নট ট্রু ইন লিঙ্গুইস্টিক টার্ম আমরা যখনই ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ ব্যবহার করছি সেই ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ টার্মের মধ্যেই দেখুন তখন কিন্তু এইগুলো কিন্তু সব হোল্ড করছে না দের আর সাম কনফিউশনস ওকে জাস্ট আই গিভ ইউ জাস্ট দিস এক্সাম্পল ডোন্ট মাইন্ড ওকে অ্যান্ড I just give you the fuzzy state. Now what is called fuzzy number? I give you the interval number, but I give the idea what is called fuzzy number. Okay. You see, there is a term that means if the maximum value of the membership, some membership values are given. Okay. If the maximum member value is 1, exactly 1, then this number is called actually fuzzy number.
So this number actually called fuzzy number if it satisfies this condition.
That means at least one of them is 1, then it is called actually fuzzy number. Okay. Now, examples of fuzzy set, you say tall man. I describe it man with height 6 feet. Okay. So there is a professor in Baroda University Mathematics, Gurachand Lai, G.C. Lai, Professor G.C. Lai is there. He is very tall man. I wrote a story about behind them. I go take jokhani dekha hota ami tai golpo ta bolta. Okay, what is tall man? Define it. To uni bazar giyechen, bazar giye bolchen je dada lebur dam koto? Bolche oi 3 taka kore piece jora nile 5 taka. বলছি এইটুকু টুকু লেবু গুলো হ্যাঁ তাতে এইগুলো 5 টাকা জোড়া 5 টাকা বলছে বাবু দোতলা থেকে দেখলেও এরকমই মনে হয় জাস্ট লাইক দ্যাট জাস্ট আমি ইংলিশে বলতাম না কি যাই হোক সো দ্যাট ইজ অ্যাকচুয়ালি দ্যাট টল ম্যান হোয়াট মানে হোয়াট টল ম্যান কে কিভাবে ডিসক্রাইব করব সো ইন টার্মস অফ ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ ইন টার্মস অফ লিঙ্গুইস্টিক টার্ম যখন আমরা ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ ব্যবহার করছি তখন দেখবে টল ম্যান ইজ ডিফাইন্ড অ্যাজ ম্যান উইথ হাইট 6 ফিট আই ডিফাইন ইট যে 6 ফুটের বেশি বড় হবে তাকে আমরা বলবো যে টল ম্যান ওকে জাস্ট আই গিভ ইউ আইডিয়া দোজ হু গেট 80% অ্যান্ড অ্যাবাভ মার্কস দে আর গুড স্টুডেন্টস সো আই গিভ দ্য মেম্বারশিপ ফাংশন 1 for those who get 80 and 100, between 80 and 100. And then membership function 9.99, that is 79.9. those who get. Okay, like that I can assign the their values. And those who get 30% below, I grade them 0 or like that, or 0.1 like that, and then we grade 20% below and then get 0. So this is the rule of assigning the membership value.
Are not these are subjective, and naturally they may differ in terms of places and in terms of persons.
Obviously.
Naturally, the better better. That is because 12 foot protein of tennis. That is 5.5 foot of the taller, tallest man.
What is the average height of man in Indian people? Okay? What is the result? It is an event. Average height of an Indian people height. Okay, what is the procedure? Amra boli ki oi bhater harite ekta bhag ke tible somosto bhag bojhay jay hoyeche kina sei karone oi draw a sample. Okay, sample ni amra test kori whether it is true or false. Okay, so that belongs to your statistics, and that is actually probability theory, and you
so
go through
random sample,
and there is a term random, so you go through mass probability theory. And then you taking the sample. Anywhere you go to Arunachal Pradesh, you go, there are some samples. But whether your procedure is wrong or correct, that is decided by that probability theory. Because of the fact that you draw the samples, those who are born tomorrow or like that, within that portion, you can measure them, so easily you can evaluate and produce that. Average height of the Indian people is 4 foot. Picked like that. So you give the result. So whether the decision is wrong or correct, that is decided by the testing of hypothesis. Okay, that is totally probability. So if you argue that the average height of all men is like that, those who are tall 6 feet, okay, that is came from your estimation. In estimation theory or like that, you can apply it, and then there is a result of that. So I can assign the membership value be 6 and like that. So all of them are actually, I think that are called linguistic variable. Actually, these variables are actually linguistic variable.
You know, that means we have to postulate some domain. In respect of domain, 6 feet. Domain of India.
Yes, that is called universe.
Domain of world, it may differ.
That is universe of discourse. I gave the natural number said is the universe of discourse I discussed previous part. Okay. Next, another example is good boys. Good boys. Boys passed in first division. Okay. You see, when I read at Chongrachar J.S. Vidyapit at Moina, মাধ্যমিকে 536 পেয়েছেন অনিরুদ্ধ গড়াই। ওকে, আমরা 600 পেয়েছি, 650 পেয়েছি, ইত্যাদি পেয়েছি, কিন্তু সে 540 তার নেই, তখনকার যে ফার্স্ট ডিভিশন ছিল সে এন্ট্রি হতে পারছে না, কোনো মতে স্কুলে ভর্তি হতে পারছে না, হেডমাস্টার অবশ্য তাকে এন্ট্রি নিলেন। ওকে, হোয়েদার ইট ইজ এ গুড বয় অর ব্যাড বয়, বিকজ ফার্স্ট ডিভিশনে পাস করেন, উচ্চ মাধ্যমিকে ওয়েস্ট বেঙ্গলে সেকেন্ড হলো এবং জয়েন্ট ইন্টারসে মেডিকেলে থার্ড হয়েছে। ওকে, হাউ ক্যান উই আইডেন্টিফাই পাস ডিভিশনে পাস করলে সে গুড বয় বাকিরা গুড বয় নয়? আমি একটু আগে এক্সাম্পল বলেছি যে আমি ভালো ছেলে প্রমাণ করুন, আমি বলেছিলাম 90% ভাব পেয়েছি বলে ভালো ছেলে, বাকিগুলো দেখলেন না সেটা বলছেন না, নম্বরটা পেলেই যে ভালো ছেলে ইট ইজ নট সো। অনেকে দেখবেন সেকেন্ড ডিভিশনে পাস করেছে, ক্লাসে গিয়ে ভালো পড়াচ্ছেন,
আগের দিনে ফার্স্ট ডিভিশন বলে দেখতে আসতো,
আর
ফার্স্ট ডিভিশন পেলে অ্যাডমিশন হয় না।
নেক্সট হচ্ছে রেড ফ্লাওয়ার্স আই সে অল রোজেস ইন্টেলিজেন্ট গার্লস রিডিং এট আইআইটি, ওকে, অল পয়েন্টস নিয়ার 5 মিন্স হোয়াট ইজ নিয়ার 5? ওকে, অ্যাডাল্টস those who persons age greater than equal to 18, that is the universal result, because voting list start from 18 years. Okay, then youngs, persons who are less than 10 years, and olds, That is greater than equal to 60 years because our retirement. Okay? And now recently it is 62. It is 62.
But what is the position of the man with age? Just specific 10 years.
Okay?
Not so, less than, but 10.
Exactly 10. I assign just young, so I assign the value 1. If it is a young set, if it is a young set, I consider the young set, then I assign the membership value 1 for 10. For 9, I assigning the membership function 9.8.